Everyone, and welcome back to a brand new video. In this one, I'm going to be showcasing how you can create the M16 assault rifle here in the Call of Duty Modern Warfare beta. So of course guys, welcome back to another video here on the channel. And if you guys didn't already know, out of every single Call of Duty game, Modern Warfare easily has the most amount of attachments per weapon. And similar to past Call of Duty games such as Black Ops 4, when you put on an attachment, it's going to be changing the look of the weapon. And with that in mind, some attachments and attachment combinations do end up changing around the look of the weapon quite a bit, and in some cases certain weapons start to resemble other weapons from previous Call of Duty games such as the M16, which of course in today's video I'll be showcasing to you guys how to create the M16 assault rifle here in Modern Warfare. And alongside that, I'm also going to be doing a mini best class setup, so if you guys go on to enjoy this video, make sure you go ahead and leave a like on it down below, as well as make sure to subscribe for more Black Ops 4 as well as Modern Warfare content. Before we get too far into this video, I do want to thank you guys for all the support on my recent Modern Warfare videos. I really do appreciate it. So yeah, now that I got the intro out of the way, let's actually dive right into the video. Alright, so as mentioned a little bit earlier in this video, how we are going to be creating the M16 assault rifle in Modern Warfare is that we are going to be equipping particular attachments on a pre-existing rifle in the game, which in turn with those attachments, the weapon is really going to start to resemble the M16 assault rifle. And of course, the only rifle in this game that you can turn into the M16 is the M4A1 carbine. Now that's the thing, you can do this exact same method for other weapons such as the AK-47. With particular attachments, you can turn it into the RPD or the AK-74U, as well as with the MP5 submachine gun. With certain attachments, you can make it resemble the Modern Warfare 3 version. And those are just two examples, being the AK-47 as well as the MP5. So if you guys would like me to make videos tackling both the AK as well as the MP5, make sure you leave your thoughts down below in the comment section. Alright, so now that I got the intro out of the way, I am going to be moving over to the class setup, and of course, as you guys can see, the class setup is going to be on your screen right now. So starting off, I am going to be diving right into the attachment portion. However, near the end of this video, I am going to be talking a little bit about the perks as well as the equipment that I used in this class setup. Alright, so of course, the first attachment that we are going to be using in this class setup is the heavy duty barrel. Now, the reason why I chose the heavy duty barrel, and that's because this one resembles the M16's way more than both the short barrel as well as the lightweight barrel do. And also, this barrel is really useful because it is going to be buffing up the damage range as well as the bullet velocity, with the only downside of this barrel being that it reduces the aim down sight speed. For our second attachment, we are going to be using the operator reflex sight, and that's just because, unfortunately, no attachment can equip the iconic M16 carrying handle to the M4A1 carbine. So with that in mind, that's how come I equipped the operator reflex sight, which is basically the red dot sight equivalent of Modern Warfare, and it still is pretty authentic because a lot of people chose to run a red dot sight when they were using the M16 in previous Call of Duty games. So yeah, moving over to our third attachment, we are going to be using the heavy stock, and the reason why, and that is this particular stock resembles the M16 quite a bit, and alongside that, it also is going to be increasing the idle sway control, and it's also going to make the weapon a lot more steady when you are going to be aiming down sight. And of course, for our fourth attachment, we are going to be using the pistol grip, and then moving over to our fifth one, we are going to be using extended mags, which is going to be resembling the magazine of the M16. Alongside that, with extended mags, we are also going to be getting an additional 15 rounds of ammunition per magazine, which from my own experience is extremely useful. So yeah guys, that's of course going to be it for the attachment portion of this class setup. So now I am going to be quickly going over both the perk as well as the equipment setup that I have for this creative class. For our secondary weapon, we are going to be using the Desert Eagle, as well as moving over to our perks. Our first perk is going to be scavenger, which is an extremely useful perk because it means we don't have to worry about running out of ammunition. Our second perk is going to be hardline, therefore making it a lot easier to get our kill streaks. And then for our final perk, we are going to be using shrapnel. And then for the equipment, I am going to be using a Semtex grenade as well as a flash grenade. So yeah guys, that's of course going to be my M16 class setup here in Modern Warfare. So if you haven't already, make sure you go ahead and try out this class setup. It's a lot of fun to use, and at least from my own experience, it does resemble the M16 quite a bit. So that's of course where I'm going to be ending off this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, don't forget to leave a like on it down below, as well as make sure to subscribe and turn on post notifications so that way you guys will not miss new upload from me. So yeah, that's of course going to be it for this video. I hope to see you in the next one.